Alleged human rights abuses inside the state penitentiary come to light in this exclusive report by Michael Deliso. An inmate details what he described as the abusive leadership at the new Bilibid prison.
This inmate who requested for anonymity has been detained at the new Bilibid prison for 3 decades. But it was only in the past 3 years, he says, that he experienced abusive leadership and rampant human rights violations on inmates in the national penitentiary.
Eh, kukunting panahon lang naman yung dinugol na 3 taon, pero yung 3 taon niya eh, parang dalawang direktor ang nangyari sa amin eh, sa higpit eh. Disiplinadong ano sir eh, may kalalagyan ka talaga.
He said he himself experienced being maltreated, the scars on his face and body proving the abuse.
May bugbog na sir, may Bartolina pa. Tingin ka lang sa kanila ng pangit sir na may mali ka na eh. May sampal ka, may tadyak pa nga sir.
Bureau of Corrections Officer in Charge Gregorio Katapang says it's not just inmates but prison employees as well who are being maltreated. Katapang says he wants to rid the culture of violence at the state penitentiary while improving the welfare of prisoners.
Yung mga mali na nangyari dito, kinokorek natin. Mm-hmm. And then of course, nagpapasok tayo ng reform agenda mm-hmm. patungkol sa pagtrato ng mga inmates mm-hmm. at saka pagtrato ng mga Bucor personnel.
Katapang also encourages PDLs to speak up and report abuses. And inmates can do this by way of electronic tablets, which they use for virtual visits by their loved ones.
Sinasabihan ko lahat ng mga inmates, no? Kung kayo inapi o pinagmasama ang loob, o kung ano man ang reklamo nyo, i-report nyo sa akin. Magbibigay nga ako ng cellphone number ko eh. Para kung ano, i-text niya lang nila. Dalawang ano yan na... Principle yan, kung pwede mong talunin yung kalaban mo, pwede kang maging istrikto o pwede kang mabait. Uh-huh. No? So, ang tingin ko, ang approach dito is magiging friendly ka sa kanila. Kasi hardened na mga yan eh. Gusto nilang bumait pero di nila magawa. Kaya kailangan naalalayan namin.
Many alleged illegal activities have been uncovered at the NBP. Including the thousands of contraband seized from inmates and the massive excavation inside the prison premises. The camp of suspended corrections chief Gerald Bantag says he is ready to answer any allegations. Michael Deliso, ABS-CBN News.
Justice Secretary De Mulia also refusing to dignify Gerald Bantag's call for him to resign. De Mulia told reporters Friday he won't even answer Bantag's challenge. Bantag earlier dared him to quit, saying Remulla has lost moral ascendancy to run the Justice Department after his son was arrested on illegal drug charges. The suspended prison's chief even said he will only surrender in the probe of the murder of broadcaster Percy Lapid if Remulla steps down from office.
Well, up to him. His lawyers know better. He should ask his lawyers what he should do.
Bantag is accused of being the mastermind of Lapid's murder.
Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the excavation site found in the new Bilibid prison was originally meant for treasure hunting. Remulla claims suspended prison's bureau chief Gerald Bantag personally told him he was digging for the Yamashita treasure, which began sometime in August or September.
Ridiculous nga eh. Tsaka... You're just wasting government time and money, eh, diba? Hindi ko alam kung government time and money ginamit niya, pero ridiculous para sa akin. You're not there to seek for treasure. You're there to run the corrections department.
In a separate interview, Bantag claimed the excavation was intended to build a deep swimming pool since he is a scuba diver. Bureau of Corrections Officer in Charge Gregorio Katapang Jr. first disclosed the matter last week. He said the tunnel, which is about 200 meters by 200 meters wide and 30 meters deep, had no paperwork and was not authorized by the Bureau.